So I said mechanism of labor as a procedure, you'll be given a pelvis and a small baby which you need to use to demonstrate mechanism of labor. So for this procedure, I've said you're going to find a pelvis, but for now she'll be our pelvis. So once you read the scenario and the scenario says demonstrate mechanism of labor, you are going to sanitize and go to the patient to get permission. In an actual situation or in the ward, you can't go and get permission to the woman who is ready for delivery. They can even slap you. Those who have delivered before, I won't deliver because I'm a man, but I've been told to have heard that you experience labor pains which are very strong. So if you are ready to deliver, you find that those labor pains are very strong. You can even slap someone who's just talking to you. Women, they even insult husbands who made them pregnant. But after delivering, so you find that the labor pains are very strong. So in an actual patient, you can't go and even get permission. When they say the baby is ready to be delivered, just don in gloves and deliver. But during osce, because you need to get yourself the 6 marks for permission, you will sanitize after reading the scenario and go to the patient. Good afternoon, Mrs. X. I'm student number 458. I've been assigned to perform mechanism of labor or to deliver your child. Can I go ahead? Anything I can do for you around here before I proceed? Thank you. I'll be back to do the procedure. You even sanitize and don in gloves. Then you're going to get the baby and go to the pelvis. You'll be demonstrating this on the pelvis. So you're going to say, the baby is lying on the right occipital anterior in longitudinal position and the presenting part is the occiput. Mechanism of labor, these are just steps or stages which the baby undertakes to negotiate through the pelvic brim. Mechanism of labor takes place during the second stage of labor. Once labor starts, the first step is descent. And descent, this is just a force that pushes the baby towards the pelvic brim. As descent is occurring, internal flexion will take place where the chin will touch the chest, the legs will come closer to the abdomen, and the hands will fold on the chest as well. As internal flexion takes place and good descent and contractions which are happening, the baby's presenting part will be pushed further towards the pelvic brim and there will be engagement. During engagement, this is just the fitting of the head in the pelvic brim. As descent and contractions are occurring, the baby's head will be further pushed downwards and there will be crowning. So there will be crowning. And during crowning, the presenting part will be the occiput. As the baby is descending, the baby will meet resistance of the pelvic floor muscles. At this particular point, the baby will there will be internal rotation of the head, and the head will turn 180 so that it is accommodated in the longest diameter, which is the anterior posterior diameter. At this particular point, the baby will even extend. There will be internal extension or extension of the head as the contractions and descent is happening throughout labor. So when extension occurs, the baby will be born up to the neck level. At this particular point, I'll go in with 2 fingers to rule out or to check if at all there's any cord around the baby's neck. If there's a cord and it is pulsating, you need to do some maneuver so that you deliver the child properly. But if there's no neck cord presentation around the neck, you will need to wait for restitution to take place. And during restitution, 2 things will happen. There will be internal rotation of the shoulders and external rotation of the head. So as the 2 shoulders are descending towards the pelvic brim, one of the 2 shoulders will meet resistance of the pelvic floor muscles and the shoulders will turn 180 so that they are accommodated in the longest diameter, which is the anterior posterior diameter. At this particular point, there will also be external rotation of the head, which will also turn 180 in a similar manner. Once this happens, I will pull the anterior shoulder in this particular manner, and the posterior shoulder will sweep through the perineum, completing a curve of colors, and I will deliver the baby onto the mother's abdomen. I will cover the baby and wipe the baby, and I will cut the cord afterwards. So Mrs. X, this is how the baby is delivered. From here, I'll advise you to continue breastfeeding the child exclusively for the first 6 months. Continue keeping the baby warm and also ensure that you come back for vaccines. Thank you so much for allowing me to deliver your child. You even remove the gloves and sanitize, and you say, I'll document and report to the ward in charge.